Welcome back. Now, over the past 10 years, one of the hottest rock bands in all of music was a band called Creed. But recently, some of the band members formed their own group called Alterbridge, and these guys rock. But we were fortunate enough to get these guys right before they perform in front of thousands of screaming fans in the UK. So now I'm sending it out to my co-host, Barbara Lanick, who's with Alterbridge. Barbara, take it away.
Thanks, Mike. I'm here at the Hammersmith Apollo in London with Mark Tremonti and Scott Phillips from the rock band Alterbridge. They're currently promoting their brand new album, AB3. So guys, how's the tour been going so far?
It's been going great. This is our fourth show, and every show gets better.
Yeah. How's the response been from your fans?
Phenomenal. Very welcoming and receptive, and it's been amazing. We're just thankful to be here.
And when will you be hitting the States?
December 10th through the 20th is our first run, and then we continue again starting the 30th through the 8th, I believe.
And musically, how's this third album different from the first two?
I think lyrically it's a little darker than the first two records. Certainly be a better question for Myles, but musically I think it's just sort of a continuation of what we've become as Alterbridge, just sort of a natural evolution and progression from the last record.
And how do you go about selecting the final tracks for your albums? I mean, that must be really difficult.
Yeah, I think we had recorded 18 and we wanted to put 11 on the record, then it became 12, then it became 13, then it became 14. You just, it's tough because you love all the songs. You just want to make a dynamic record and have it equally balanced. So with this record, we didn't want anybody to be unhappy, so we just threw all 14 out of 18 on there to make everybody happy.
Thank you so much for
your
time.
Thank you.
I'm Barbara Lanick from London. Back to you, Mike, in sunny Miami Beach.
Thanks, Barbara. Great piece. Those guys rock. I can't wait for those guys to come to the States. Now, recently, the JW Marriott had a grand opening in downtown Miami. And we were there for Brooke Shields, Anna Kournikova, A-Rod, and Angie Harmon. So, Natalie, take it away.
Thanks, Mike. Hey, guys. I'm Natalie Renee, and I'm here at the grand opening of the world's first JW Marriott Marque property. This upscale hotel features a full entertainment facility with basketball, tennis, golf. This you don't want to miss. Plus, we're going to catch up with some of the celebrities who made it out to celebrate. Let's go check it out. Tennis star Anna Kournikova, how are you tonight?
Good, how are you?
Doing good, you look great. I love your shoes.
Thank you.
Now, I understand you're just doing a lot of traveling and charity work. Tell us about that as well.
Well, I travel still a lot for exhibition matches, tennis exhibition matches, charity matches. I'm going next week to play with Elton John and Billie Jean King in Washington on the 15th for Elton's AIDS Foundation that I've been doing every year. And just got back from Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia a few weeks ago, where we played also exhibition match. But, you know, I love playing tennis still. It's still a huge part of my life, but I also am very, very involved with Boys and Girls Club, especially the one here in Miami.
Hey guys, I'm here with DJ Irie. How are you doing tonight?
Doing amazing, absolutely amazing. It's a wonderful night in Miami.
Are you going to be DJing for the celebrity basketball tournament that they have going on tonight, or are you gonna be playing?
What? I'm not gonna be doing both. I'm going to be DJing and hosting it up a little bit, and then when I go out to do my thing, I may deal with Tim. So Tim will hold down the tables and the microphone while I do my thing. So I'm going to be doing both. I mean, I can let all these basketball skills go to waste now, can't I?
I just finished doing Leap of Faith at the Amundsen in Los Angeles, and it's a Broadway. It's new Alan Menken, and it's the two, I'm one of them, and then the other lead is Raul Esparza, who's from Miami. And so I have an extra affinity for Miami because he's an amazing person. And we'll be heading to Broadway. So we're right now in the middle of that.
Well, it's obviously a very exciting event. I mean, obviously I'm from Miami, so I'm in love with the city. And I just think it's one of the greatest cities in the world. It's very exciting to be part of such a beautiful hotel. I mean, it has over 300 rooms. It has a huge fitness center, entertainment center, like they like to call it. And I think it's just another great asset that Miami has to offer. Well, I think the most special thing that we've had is, you know, winning the world title last year in 2009. That's probably been the highlight of my career. We came up a little short in 2010, but I know that we're getting to gear up and hopefully get a run at the championship next year.
I'm here with Angie Harmon. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. How are you?
Now, you play a homicide detective on the hit TV show Rizzoli and Isles, and in fact, that is your actual dream job, correct?
It is.
Now, you were recently given the opportunity to play a day in the life of a real homicide detective. What was that experience like?
You know, it wasn't at all what I expected. I mean, I was kind of looking forward to like blood and guts and gore and ooh and scary and all of that. And, you know, I just found that it was more respectful and more serene and more kind-hearted, if you will. You know, I look up to them. I mean, I thank God every day for those kind of people. I want to do that job, but I don't know that I'm ever going to get the chance to. But, you know, they're very special people, you know, and so I can only hope that Jane just sort of mirrors anything, you know, that they do.
Fantastic. It's great to be back. It's great for a cause and also incredible hotel, so they did a great job.
Have you had a chance to walk around and see all the amenities yet?
Not yet. I just got here. Hopefully, we're going to have fun out there and enjoy the event.
Well, guys, I've had a blast so far. This hotel is truly for those looking for leisure and amusement. I can't wait to see what the rest of the night is going to bring. Back to you, Mike.
Wow, thanks, Natalie. What a magnificent hotel. Now it's time for a quick commercial break, but when we come back, I go one-on-one with my future wife, the beautiful Miss Paula Abdul. We'll be right back.
Coming up next, the annual Make-A-Wish Foundation Ball with special guest host Paula Abdul. Then we see how Halloween looks in Miami. We'll be right back.
Hey guys, if you want to see more live performances, interviews, and exclusive footage, check out my app. Go to the iPhone or Droid and put in the search bar On the Mic, Mike Sherman. Welcome back. Now, the Make-A-Wish Foundation is an amazing charity that raises money for kids all over America. And recently, they had the Make-A-Wish Ball right here in Miami. And this year's master of ceremony was the beautiful Miss Paula Abdul. So I was there front and center to talk about this fantastic charity and our new show coming up on CBS. Let's take a look. Hi, everybody. You watch On the Mic with yours truly, Mike Sherman, down here at the Make-A-Wish Ball at the beautiful Intercontinental Hotel with this year's MC, the beautiful Paula Abdul. Paula, congratulations. Great career. But for tonight is your event. Talk a little bit about it.
Tonight is an event for unbelievable, courageous young people that are going to get their wishes fulfilled. And we're going to raise lots of money, which is a wonderful thing. I am such a big fan of the Make-A-Wish Foundation. I've been a big supporter from the humble beginnings of my career, and will continue to do so.
We've been covering this event for several years, and every year it gets bigger and better. To have you represent this brand is it's a fantastic thing. I mean, what was it like getting a call from Sharif and some of the founders of the event and say, Paula, we want you to represent us?
To get a phone call to be actively involved with the Make-A-Wish Foundation is always a welcome gift. Kids are such a big part of my life, and I love nurturing and fostering their talent, and I've always felt like I'm a dream maker, so this is incredible for me.
Well, you are. You know, my show is a weekend syndicated show in 40 million homes, and it's music-based.
Wonderful.
So everybody out there is going to see that. Now, you have a new show coming out, so we're going to go ahead and promote that. When are we expecting this to come out, broadcast, or debut, and talk a little bit about it?
This is thrilling for me. This is like a big gift for me in a shiny box. It really is. It's called Live to Dance, and we premiere on CBS January 4th with the 2-hour special, and then we're on every Wednesday. It's going to be an incredible competition. It celebrates the spirit and psyche of dancers, and we have dancers from 5-year-olds to 100+, and it's been incredible. All different styles of dance. It's beautiful.
Name of the show?
Live to Dance.
So this spring is coming out, or this winter?
No, it comes out in the first week of January. January 4th is our season premiere.
Paula, I've been a fan of yours way back.
You have been, for real?
Before Brad, before everybody. I've always, you know, I'm a Jewish guy, and, you know, I always said one day I'm going to marry Paula Abdul. But, you know, interviewing you is the second best thing. thank you so much, and congratulations on a fantastic career, and I wish you nothing but success moving forward.
Thank you so much. Hi, this is Paula Abdul, and you're watching On the Mic with Mike Sherman, my future husband.
Wow, what an amazing woman. Paula, would you marry me? And all you guys can come to the wedding. Well, guys, that's our show for this week. I really hope you enjoyed it. But tune in for next week's show, where it's going to be fantastic. But before we go, let's go out to Sagafredo's on Lincoln Road for their annual Halloween party. So you guys keep watching, and I can bring you the stars. I'm Mike Sherman. I'll see you next week.
One day you're up, the other day you're down, and you're lost your pretty face on your shirt cut to the top. Now you're stuck to me and I'm stuck to you, girl.